was a long, difficult battle. But we have taken the castle at Heifei and delivered a crushing blow to Wei. The long conflict that started at Chi Bi is at last over. Only Shu stands in our way now, and they are led by Liu Bei's son, Liu Chan, a ruler known far and wide for his foolishness. Before long, all the land will belong to Wu. Father, brother, watch over me in battle, for you will see that your dreams have not died, but are on the verge of becoming reality.
The day to attack Shu has finally come. The Three Kingdoms strategy devised by Master Shu Ye Liang shall end in victory for you, my lord. My lord, you must defend our center. Both flanks of our army should surround the enemy, and when our rear guard comes forward, wipe them out. The battle shall take place at Bai Di Castle. The enemy commander is Liu Chan. Unlike his father Liu Bei, he has no ability to rule the land. Now it is time to put an end to Shu and give the land to Wu.
Get out of my way.
Now the Three Kingdoms divided by Zhuge Liang shall be as one.
Let's go. This has long been the dream of my family. Today it shall be realized!
My lord! Victory is almost ours! It will not be long before you achieve what your brother had always dreamed of.
Wang Gai, let's win the day and then drink until morning.
Whatever you say, that sounds mighty good to me.
Charge! This whole land will soon be ours!
We'll surround Bai Di Castle. The main army shall protect the center. Wang Gai will begin encirclement from the left flank, while Zhou Tai secures a space for our reinforcements on the right.
This is our country, and we'll defend it ourselves.
You seem a bit cocky. You obviously know nothing of battle.
I shall show no mercy.
We'll crush them in an instant.
So, Wu would attack even the innocent.
I shall show no mercy.
To die on the battlefield. Such good fortune.
Enemy officer defeated.
Burn them to the ground! Impressive, Lord Sun Quan.
If they're so eager to die, then we'll be happy to oblige them.
Defeated.
Alive shall pass. Avoid a battle, fight!
I shall show no mercy.
Blade will make you pay for your injustice.
I shall show no mercy.
This is not going very well.
Officer defeated.
Ah!
Impressive, Lord Sun Quan.
My spear will run right through to your soul.
Beast of Shi Liang, have you sharpened your fangs?
I shall show no mercy.
Fangs are for the weak. I fight this, the spear of justice, forged in the fires of virtue.
Jiao Tai, leave this to us and return to our master.
You fulfilled your duty.
Go and treat your wounds.
Thank you.
I'll cut you in half with the sharp edge of justice.
I shall show no mercy.
We must focus on defense in order to assess the battlefield.
My spear will run right through to your soul.
Beast of Shi Liang, have you sharpened your fangs?
I shall show no mercy.
Fangs are for the weak. I fight with this, the spear of justice, forged in the fires of virtue.
Jiao Tai, lead this to us and return to our master.
You fulfilled your duty. Go and treat your wounds.
Thank you.
I shall show no mercy.
I'll cut you in half with the sharp edge of justice. Justice never fails.
The Sun family makes its own justice.
I shall show no mercy.
For our reinforcements.
officer defeated.
Master, the time has come. Order the army to march.
Missions left unfulfilled.
Enemy officer defeated.
Such impressive skill. I could learn something from you.
I've spotted the enemy commander!
My ambitions left unfulfilled.
Enemy officer defeated. Enemy officer defeated. I shall show no mercy. Show no mercy. Enemy officer defeated.
Ah!
seen everything.
Enemy commander, prepare yourself.
I shall show no mercy.
Unfulfilled.
Enemy officer defeated.
We captured Bai Di Castle and killed Liu Chan as well, bringing an end to Shu and its dreams of a land of virtue. Perhaps it was too great of an ideal to be realized. What the people want is to live a life of peace. And the Kingdom of Wu shall be able to give that life to them. We must work hard to create a land that would not be ridiculed by Cao Cao or Liu Bei.
It was during the final days of the year 200 AD when the Han Dynasty saw its end. Its demise ushered in a new era of chaos, brought on by several regional lords vying to rule China. There were those who sought absolute power, as well as those who fought for justice, and some simply fought for the sake of their beliefs. Many would rise and fall in their attempts to dominate the land. Sun Quan from the Wu territory, second son of Sun Jian and younger brother of Sun Se. Following the untimely deaths of his father and brother, Sun Quan became the ruler of Wu at the tender age of 19. Although he was not as capable a warrior as his father and brother, he had an extraordinary ability in bringing the people together in his kingdom. Always lending an ear to those around him, he made sure to build a solid foundation for his empire. In 208 AD, the first test of Sun Quan's abilities would reveal itself. Having already taken the Huabei region, Cao Cao had begun marching his mighty army south towards Wu. Refusing to surrender, Sun Quan became allies with Liu Bei and engaged Cao Cao at Chi Bi. Due to the amazing skills of Zhou Yu and Huang Gai, Sun Quan was somehow able to win the battle against Cao Cao. Time would pass, and the land would be divided between Shu, Wei, and Wu. Eager to fulfill his father and brother's ambitions, he daringly engaged Shu and Wei and prevailed over both. After countless battles, the land was finally at peace. However, the end of the chaos did not signify the end of Sun Quan's efforts. He would continue to build his empire so it may last forever. These tales, passed on for generations, have endured the tests of time and live on even today.
Father, brother, now behold, this entire land now belongs to Wu. Ah, a new age awaits us. Now, let us meet it together.
Thank you.